Mr. President, thank you for receiving our interview. Well, since October, a number of Olympic qualifiers have been held across all three competition zones. How would you evaluate the overall preparation so far?
So the preparations for the Olympic Winter Games are well underway, and I think that we all, the athletes, the organizers, and fans are very much looking forward to when the games will finally begin.
What would you say is the past among athletes thinks it's going to be a very special kind of winter games, given the COVID-19 measures in place and predominantly Chinese audience for the competitions?
Well, we are living in unprecedented times, and that certainly has an effect on the organization and implementation of the games. But for the athletes, the Olympic Games remain the Olympic Games in the end. The spirit, the magic, the emotions linked to the participation will be evident no matter what. Because the Olympics are a place where athletes from all over the world meet, where years of hard work will be rewarded, and where dreams come true.
And besides being held during the pandemic, what for you is the most distinct feature about Beijing 2022 compared to previous Olympic Games?
Well, our ambition is always that big events like the Olympics also leave a legacy and continue to have an impact on society when the athletes are long gone. Beijing has set the standard very high. If you look at the city venues for these Olympics, most of them go back to the 2008 Summer Games. For the Winter Olympics, I see the same long-term vision and many FIS venues that will continue to be used in the future for recreational purposes as well as competition sites.
Your federation has set up the Chinese office in Beijing, the first ever overseas office of yours. What does that say about your commitment to the Chinese winter sports industry? Do you see lots of potential in this market ever, even after the Olympics?
The work doesn't stop with the Olympics. It continues long after the Olympic Games. China is one of the most important global markets and has great potential for growth. And I'm very impressed by how China has made the development of snow sports a priority. A country with the ambition to bring 300 million people to our sports is an amazing opportunity. And with the office, we're able to operate directly in China and promote the progression of both recreational and professional snow sport in the country. And I'm convinced that this will further strengthen the global presence of our sport and also bring it to the next level.